as you all know, I'm kind of a nerd when it comes to Kajabi, and so I'm kind of geeking out today. I'm kind of like super excited over all these features and all these changes that are coming. Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel. It has been a little while since I have produced a video, and I wanted to jump in now because there are so many exciting things happening over at Kajabi. They have been releasing so many new updates since last year and into definitely this year. And just over this last month in January, they've released so many new features into Kajabi that I'm extremely excited about, because some of these features are ones that I actually suggested years ago. Now, I don't know if that's why they actually went with them, but I actually suggested them the moment I switched over to Kajabi from another really popular app, because they were features that that app had that I really wanted to see implemented in Kajabi, and it's now coming to fruition. And so I'm really excited. And of course, as you all know, I'm kind of a nerd when it comes to Kajabi, and so I'm kind of geeking out today. I'm kind of like super excited over all these features and all these changes that are coming. And not only Kajabi changes, but if you haven't been following me on social media, there are a lot of changes going on in my business right now. I'm revamping all of my coaching products. Unlock Kajabi is getting a new course name, Kajabi Launchpad. It's going to be part of the community now. My community is now live, my free community. You'll find links to all this stuff in the description below. My paid advanced Kajabi newsletter, Keeping It Kajabi, will be releasing really, really soon. And Master Kajabi is also on its way, which is my advanced course and membership for people who really just want to master Kajabi and be complete Kajabi nerds like me. So there's definitely a lot of changes coming to my side of the business and a lot of assets that I'm creating for you as Kajabi users in order to up your game. If you are not a Kajabi user yet, you can always jump on and join our clan over at michaelgoms.com/Kajabi. You'll get a free 30-day trial of Kajabi, which is double the trial that they have on their website. And you'll also gain access immediately to the Kajabi Launchpad course, which is kind of a self-guided course. You get a free 45-minute coaching call with moi to go over your setup or help you get started with either strategy or with the tech. You also gain access to my 30 Days to Profits ebook, which is just chocked full of helpful tips, guides, strategies in order to help you start making money in your first 30 days so that we take advantage of that free trial that you're going to be on when you sign up under my link, right? Just as a disclaimer, or just to kind of let you know how this works, if you sign up under my link, I simply receive a portion of your Kajabi payment every single month. It doesn't cost you any extra. So as my thank you for signing up through my link, that's why I provide you these assets for free. You'll also gain access, I forgot to mention, to our free community where you can get ongoing Kajabi help from me and other Kajabi users that are members of our community. I'm really excited because we have all these changes coming to Kajabi. I have all these changes coming to my programs. We're not going to talk about all those changes in this video, but I am going to be releasing a couple videos here soon that'll explain a little bit more about my products and services. Obviously, you can find all the links in the description below, including Kajabi Done For You services, which I forgot to mention. But in this video specifically, we're going to focus on the saved sections in Kajabi, because this is one of my ultimate all-time features that I've been wanting in Kajabi. And as you can tell, I'm really excited about this because I've been waiting for this for a very long time. So without further ado, let's jump into my website builder and I'll show you what exactly the saved sections are and how they work and how it can really speed up your workflow working in Kajabi. Okay, so let's jump over into my dashboard. This is my Kajabi dashboard. I'm under the design tab on the left-hand side, as you can see. And this is where, if you're new to Kajabi, this is where you'd go to access all your website pages, immediately get into your design like really quick, access your landing pages, as you can see here on the left, your navigation, so your menus and your blog. So basically anything that has to do with your website is gonna be under this website tab. First, I'm going to show you exactly what a saved section is, and I'm going to show you how to access it and how to save something. And then I'm going to go over a little bit more of the details on which pages this actually works on. I think the first thing that I should mention is that saved sections, so sections that you build on your website that you want to save and use somewhere else without having to copy it, because until now we've had to, and I've even had to help my students do this, and we put one page side by side, the new landing page and the old landing page. And I would literally just sit there and help them copy every little thing over. It was still faster, like I could do it faster than them, but it was still very tedious and very time consuming. So this feature is a godsend, and I'm gonna show you how this works. But the first thing I should say is that if you're going from your system website page to a landing page, which I'm gonna show you the difference really quick, that doesn't work. It has to be website to website page or landing page to landing page. And it even works in the email builder, the email campaign builder. I'm going to show you that in a second as well. So real quick, let me show you the difference between the website and the landing pages. If we go to the left-hand side, you're going to click under just either website pages, landing pages. As you can see here on the tabs, you got your website landing, your funnels, and your A-B split test, which I'm going to show you in a sec, because this feature actually works in your A-B split test, and I'm going to show you a cool feature on like how to utilize that. These, under the website tab, as you can see here on the right-hand side, they're all labeled system, okay? Except for down here, you got a draft and you got a published, okay? These are pages that I'm really not doing anything with because I built my about page out as a landing page. But if it's labeled system page, this is where, like, if I want to save a section from my system homepage, like this top page, right, it will work. I can save it as a section, and then I can pull up the store or my library, even my newsletter page, and I can use that section in these system pages. But as long as it's under this section, if I jump over here and I'm going to click the tab landing pages, any landing page, you can use that save section in any other landing page. And one thing that I should mention really quick is that you have to be on the same theme. So if you're using the Premiere theme, you need to be on the Premiere theme on the page that you're adding the section to. That's one of the limitations right now, but they did mention in the beta rollout video today that they are working on the compatibility across, you know, from website pages to landing pages. So that should be coming in the near future. So look forward to that. I'm really excited. So there's many ways to get into the page builder. I'm going to come right down here to home, and I'm just going to click on it right here. All right, here we are in the page builder. And if you're not familiar with the page builder, this is going to be a great opportunity for you to check this out. And like I said, go sign up for that free 30-day trial, because that's the best way to get familiar with all of these features, is just to get in, poke around, test drive it, watch a whole bunch of my tutorials, and learn how to use Kajabi effectively. Again, if you have any questions, I do offer coaching, I do offer done-for-you services, and of course, you can join our free newsletter, free community, all this stuff. You can get help with all that stuff. So, all right, so let's start on the left-hand side. For those of you who aren't familiar, these are all your sections that are on your homepage. If you see this little eye icon and it's crossed out, that just means that's something that I have hidden on the homepage, that either a section I'm currently not using, which now I'm excited about, because there are sections on here that I'm not using on this page and I don't plan to. I was just kind of messing around, but I developed a really nice section. Now I can save it into the save sections area and then delete it off of this page. It doesn't mess with your save sections. And that's another thing I should mention really fast too, is that it does not cross-populate. So unfortunately, but that's okay. If you create a section on your homepage like this that I'm going to show you, and you save it into a save section, if you later make changes to that section, let's say after you've used that section on another page, if you make changes to the original section, it will not cross-populate. It won't change across wherever you've added that section. So what you have to do is just make the change, resave the section, and just label it the same name, and then just delete your old one, and then re-add it to the other page. So there's a little bit of a workflow, but it's way better than having to put up page by page and do it manually, I'm telling you. All right, let's go down here on the left-hand side. I'm going to show you, well, actually, let's scroll down here on the homepage here. So let's try this Aspiring Entrepreneur podcast section. And I'm going to see if I can find it here. I have a lot of ones that are hidden here. Okay. I think it's this one right here. So podcast, right? So we're going to click into this. And as you can see, there's a new button here, okay, called Save Section. It's literally that simple. So once I've built this out, I'll just click on the canvas to make sure we're in the right section. And let's say I got this exactly to where I want it. And right now this is exactly where I want it. And so now I want to use it on another page. So I'm going to click Save Section. Now I've already saved this section, but I'm just going to show you. What you want to do is give it a name. And what I've decided to do is give it, like, you want to come up with really good naming conventions, because there is a search option inside the sections, which is fantastic. And so you want to come up with your own naming conventions so that you remember kind of what you're looking for when you need to be able to pull it up. If you're on another page or another landing page, you want to be able to pull it up. The simplest one for this one that I came up with so far is just like home podcast. That way I'm referencing where it came from, and then I'll know what section that it actually is. And I'll show you in a second. It's really cool. Let's hit save, and then I'll show you, because it actually shows a thumbnail of your section. Okay, it says save section now that it's saved. So now let's go back to the homepage and let's go up to the top. And let's say we wanted to just add that podcast section, like right below my main header here, okay? So what we're gonna do over the left-hand side, scroll all the way down to where it says add section. So we're gonna click add section. And now you can see this new button right at the top here, this new option for saved sections. So click on save sections and this cool new window pops up. And I love looking at this window, it's so cool. So right now you can see that you can actually search right here. You can search for a section. You can also sort all your sections over here by like recently saved, the name, last used. Last used, especially if it's really popular, that makes it so much quicker and easier to access. And Sorry, I'm just in love with this feature. So as you can see here, if I click on Home Podcast, we give it a sec, it's going to load a preview image of that section. See, it's right there. So you know exactly what you're about to put on your new existing page. It's literally that easy. The only thing, like I mentioned, you can't really edit it. So if you want to make changes, you got to go back to the original, make the change, and then resave it. But as long as you're not making any major changes or anything, the thing you can change is you can change the name. So if I click on these three dots, you can click rename, name in a new naming convention. And now if you want to add it here, we're just going to click add to page. Oh, and it loaded it at the bottom of the page, but here you go. So added it to the bottom of the page, and then we would just drag it up to the top. We'll put it right underneath my header. So now if we scroll down, you'll see that now we have, there's our podcast section and there's our other podcast section. One last thing that I want to show you really quick is how it can also be used in email campaigns. And this is amazing. I love this. So let's jump over into one of my dental emails originally that was going out. It works exactly the same way. So we're here in the email page builder, which again, thing I love about Kajabi the most is that the page builder is consistent across the board, even when you're designing your emails, your email campaigns. So let's say you like the way this section right here, take action and let's get those chairs filled. Let's say you like the way this section looks, you want to save it. Again, right here, click save section. We're going to name this our sign off, which I probably should add my image to that so it's not two separate sections. That would probably help. So there's our sign off, right? So we're going to go back. And now if we come down here to add section, now we just go up here to saved sections. And here you can see sign off. We're going to click on that. Again, it'll showcase it right here. All we have to do is click add to page. And there you go. It added it right down there. And so if I would have saved the sections that I love in here, what's great about this is create your sign offs, create your headers in here, save those. And then all you got to do is literally click over. What's great about this is whatever the settings that you have in your style guide, like your colors, your fonts, things like that, when you, even if you saved this section under another email that had another setting, it's going to adopt the current settings for whatever you've set for this email sequence or this email. So if you've changed the colors, you change the fonts, things like that, it will adopt and adapt automatically. And that's really cool because then you don't have to go back in and fix all the branding. So that is basically it for saved sections in Kajabi. Like I said, I'm so excited for this feature and I'm just geeking out on it. So if you guys have questions about this feature or any comments about it, definitely comment, ask below. I try to answer all the questions in the comments that I'm possibly able to. Couple more things that I want to mention really quick, and you will find all the links in the description below. Again, if you don't have Kajabi, go to michaelgoms.com/Kajabi, get access to that course and community, as well as the free 45-minute coaching call so we can get on. I can kind of walk you through the setup and that free ebook. And of course, you get me as a coach, which what else is more awesome than that, right? Again, something else that I want to mention, and you'll find the link in the description below as well, is that the Kajabi Launchpad course, which used to be Kajabi Kickstart, and then it was Unlock Kajabi 7-Day Success Plan, now it's Kajabi Launchpad, is for sale. So if you already have Kajabi, but you need a really robust beginner kind of course to get you set up and running, it's kind of a self-guided course, right? And you really need that, find the link in the description below, go there, pick yourself up a copy, join us in there and in the community, and we will get you set up and running as fast as possible. And of course, I would love it if you subscribe to my YouTube channel. So I hope you stick around here and join us here in our wonderful YouTube community that we have going on here. So thanks a lot, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.